Hello and welcome to Infinity. There are three erase brushes which aren't always used so much, but so let's have a look at them. If you right click over here, you can see there's an erase brush, which you normally see. Underneath that's a background erase brush and a flood erase brush. And these are similar to other brushes, but they have an erase function. So let's have a quick look at what they do. I'm going to start off, I'm going to put a layer fill layer in. Let's make that blue so we can see what it is, and we'll drag it underneath. So the first erase brush we have here, we quite simply, when we paint on something over here, there we go. If I click on the background there, when I paint on here, effectively what's happening, I'm painting through to the blue layer underneath, so you can see. So if I take the blue layer off, you can see it goes all the way through. So this is useful when you have made some selection on a layer and you want to get through further down. So what were they on about there? So for example, I've got a new pixel layer above here. I go to the paintbrush tool and say I want to do a color change up here, say to another color, say a magenta there. And I'm painting on this here, trying to get to the edge. And I kind of overlap a bit there, and you know, down here I might bring this down, but you know, then I'm kind of overlapping the edges of this, and I want to erase back to it. So I hit erase on using an erase brush on this. What I can do, a way of knowing it if it's a solid color, is I turn the opacity down. I can see where those edges are. So now if I go to the erase brush, and opacity 100% to do that, hardness. Yeah, something probably in the middle, so I can take a couple of goes at it, and I can just paint on the edge here. You can see where this is getting to the edge of that. There we go. Oops, over painted that, but I can always paint that back again and so on. But just to show what that is, let's go back to the paintbrush, and I can see I can paint in here. So you can alternate between the paintbrush and the erase brush, and then if I turn that all the way up, see I've erased along the edge there, and even though I can see something missing there, I can still go down over that again. So that's the erase brush, but underneath there there's a couple more. So let's just look at this one and say right click on the erase brush, go down to the background erase brush, and we'll get rid of the pixel layer because you can see what this does here. What this is like is, this is like the color replacement brush up here. So if I right click the paintbrush, the color replacement there, that samples the color and then paints in a color, but you get the same effect here. The background erase brush, it samples the color and then tries afterwards, looks to erase that color until it sees something different. So as I get to the edge of this, see, I'm now painting here and it's not going past because it's sampled the orange. It's only painting to erase the orange. So this is a way of erasing an area. And so if I could do this color change this way around by having a color underneath here and erasing the top one. And with this, I've got the usual paintbrush things up here. And I can, down here, I can sample it continuously, which means it'll keep going, which is probably not very helpful. The main thing here that's useful is tolerance. And that's, yeah, how many different, in this case, oranges here, that see at the edge there, it's, you might need the tolerance up a little bit more for that. So anyway, that is the background erase brush. And the third one is the flood erase tool. And this is very similar to the flood fill tool, but it doesn't erase. So if I click on this blue here, you'll see it just went out as far as it could, looking for similar ones here. And again, tolerance is actually the only control here. So there, if you wanted to get rid of that blue, the tolerance was probably a bit high for that, because it let it go further out into other different colors. So there we go, three different erase brushes. The top one just erases. The second one samples and then erases only that colour. And the flood arrays will erase an area until it kind of fills in. It's very similar to the background arrays brush. But the flood arrays tool looks like the flood fill tool, and the background arrays is like the colour replacement. Okay, that's about it. Three quite useful erase brushes. Hope you like them and hope you find them useful. And thank you very much for watching.